Okay, so I am Thakre madam. I am a faculty for your division to teach subject basic electrical engineering. Okay, my sound, is it okay, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
I have completed my post graduation in electrical engineering control system. Okay, so in this semester I will be taking your basic electrical engineering lectures. Okay, so how many units that is for this? I'll show you syllabus. I think structure, you know, for this subject?
No, ma'am.
Okay, we'll show you. Okay, yes, it is there on website. All of you also download it. I'll share you here. Okay, can everyone see this academic structure?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so see, this is basic electrical engineering subject. Total 4 units are there. Okay, in this semester you are going to learn total 4 units. So if you observe this, you can find here for basic electrical engineering per week 2 lectures are there. Can everyone see this? ET10203A, basic electrical engineering. Okay, so here for theory 2 lectures per week will be conducted for this subject, and you have 2 hours practical. For lectures you have to go division wise, means all students whatever is the strength 75-70 together lecture will be conducted. Okay, and what's about for practical? We divide total number of students into 3 batches. Okay, suppose first 25 in D1 batch, next 25 in D2, and the rest in D3 batch, like this. So for practical, every week you have to go batch wise. Your practical per week is of 2 hours for basic electrical engineering. Okay, so you have to go for that batch wise, and every batch having practical of 2 hours, 1 practical. Okay, so for practical 1 credit is there, and for lecture for 1 hour 1 credit. Okay, and for practical for 2 hours 1 credit, means like this total 3 credit are there. Okay, here you can see last one column, 3 credits for electrical engineering. Okay, now next, if you see this structure, next column is CE. C means what? Continuous evaluation. Okay, so this continuous evaluation, it is based on assignments given to you, and these assignments based on theory contents. Okay, so for theory total 4 units are there. After 2 unit we'll conduct one, we'll give you one assignment. It is of 40 marks. Okay, that you have to solve and submit. Then again after 3rd and 4th unit we'll give you assignment based on last 2 units, that is 3rd and 4th. Again it will be of 40 marks. So 40 plus 40, total 80, and 80 will be reduced to 20. Clear? Okay, so like this continuous evaluation, this 20 marks will be given to you based on assignments. For electrical engineering this subject, we are going to conduct 2 assignments for all division, 8 divisions. Okay, this subject is for module 1 students, that is first 8 division. Okay, so for all divisions what we have planned, 2 assignments will be conducted. After first 2 units, first assignment 40 mark, and after last 2 units, second assignment 40 marks, 80 marks will be reduced to 20. Clear? Next is in same exam, it is of 30 marks and it is based on first 2 units. Okay, and next column is this next to it, that is ESE, end same exam, and ISE is in same exam. So if you see, marks for in same and end same exam are 30-30. Okay, so in same exam is based on first 2 units. and end sem exam is based on last two units. Both will be conducted at the end of semester on the same day. Due to pandemic situation, this corona, what we have planned, otherwise what is done, in same exam after first two units and same exam after last two units, like this is the schedule. But due to this pandemic situation, what we have planned, in same exam based on first two units and end same exam based on last two units, both are of 30-30 marks each, okay, will be conducted on the same day at the end of semester. Okay, and SCE skill competency evaluation. So see, for this practical is of 2 hours for this subject. So total 6 experiments are there. In every week we finish 1 experiment. So like this 6 weeks, it will take to complete 6 experiments. And after 6 weeks over, once 6 experiments over, it starts with PBL, that is project based learning. Means one topic will be, you can select on your own any topic, suppose what we can say, solar system, that is the or another one, what we can say, wiper, rainwater indicator, okay, like this, any topic you can select on your own, smart dustbin, like this, which includes hardware, that is, it's a combination of electrical and electronics. Now, nothing is pure electrical, okay, nowadays, all the branches are interdisciplinary, any topic related to electrical and electronics, combination of both you have to select, and based on that, what every year we ask students to submit hardware, okay, but due to pandemic situation we have changed it, only PPT or seminar, on that you will get asked to present. Got it? Seminar PPT, you have to present on any topic related to electrical engineering, like thermal power plant you can select, battery, like this topic, or generator, motor, how it works. Nowadays various advanced instruments available, so on that also you can give seminar or presentation. So based on that you will get 30 marks. This one SCE 20 marks, SCE, that is 20 marks. Okay, you will get based on that 20 marks. Clear to you? SCE for what? And last one, if you observe, 25 marks are there for term work. Here it is written, practical, oral and term work. It includes 25 marks. Okay, so for this, this 25 marks, you will be given it based on 6 experiments. Okay, during practical, you are going to perform total 6 experiments in this semester. So what we have done, after 3 experiments, 1 quiz we will conduct. Okay. And after last 3 experiments, second quiz we will conduct. Suppose consider it is of 30-30 marks. First one quiz 30 marks, second one quiz 30 marks, and 60 will be reduced to 25. Okay. Clear to you how 125 marks for this subject you will get? Clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. If you have any difficulty, you can ask. Okay, so in this subject, total 4 units we are going to cover. See, this subject is new to you, basic electrical engineering. So, what I'll suggest that everyone please be attentive in this lecture. Listen each and every point. 100% syllabus will be covered, that is before assignment 1, all means numericals of all types on each topic I will conduct, theory also, first of all theory I will explain to you, and based on that then numerical, like this is the system for this subject, okay, initially theory and then later on numericals on that topic. Okay, more weightage is there in this subject is for numericals compared to theory. Okay, so on each and every topic numericals you will get asked, for assignments also, for in-sem exam also, end-sem exam also. Material also I will pass on to you, whatever my lecture recordings, that also I will share with all of you. Again, whatever the notes, means PPT I am going to present during this lecture, that also will share. Which books you have to refer, that also I share with all of you. No need to purchase anything, everything in soft copy I have. I will share with you. If you want, you can take its print out. Got it? Okay. So for this subject, B.L. Thareja Volume 1 and Volume 2 is required. Someone post here can't hear. But I think no one is getting such problem. I think everyone can hear me properly.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So someone posted, you please sound settings from your side. Okay. What's about books? B.L. Thareja Volume 1, B.L. Thareja Volume 2. Only transformer you have to study from B.L. Thareja Volume 2. Otherwise, rest three units are in B.L. Thareja Volume 1. I have soft copy of both the books. Okay, these are the reference book, textbook, means authenticate these two books. Again, you can refer V.K. Mehta also. I have soft copy of it, will share with you. Actually, if you see B.L. Thareja Volume 1, more than 1000 pages it has. Okay, but what are the contents related to your syllabus? Hardly 200 to 300 pages. Okay, or maybe less than that. So only that number of pages, you attend my lecture, whatever the topic I conduct during lecture, the same topic you read from B.L. Thareja Volume 1, V.K. Mehta, Edward Hughes, these are the books, but B.L. Thareja Volume 1 is sufficient. Along with that, you can use V.K. Mehta. More than sufficient. Okay. So what you can do, if you want hard copy, B.L. Thareja Volume 1 is available online also. You also can download from your end, but I will also share soft copy. Okay. Here, whatever the topics there in your syllabus, that number of pages only you take print out. Okay. No need to purchase a book, because all contents not there in your syllabus, hardly whatever the contents of B.L. Thareja Volume 1, hardly 20% included in your syllabus. Okay. Every year actually 6 units are there, but due to this pandemic situation, we have reduced syllabus. So 4 units only included in your syllabus. Okay. Rather than 6. What else? So this is about the books. Material I will pass on. Books and again one local author book which is not authenticate. Local author means what? Which is not authenticate, but it is good for numerical practice. If you see B.L. Thareja, V.K. Mehta, hardly 1-2 numerical on each topic they solved there. The rest all are unsolved numerical and only answer they put there. Okay, but not necessarily every student can solve the numerical. So for numerical practice, local author book also, it's a scan Xerox scan copy I have. That soft copy I will pass on to you. Only numerical practice, for numerical practice you use it. Okay. And there number of numericals given solved. So for numerical practice, local author book also I'll share. Someone posted SCE. Again, I'll repeat here. See, first one component CE. It is of 20 marks based on assignment. After first and second unit, assignment number 1 of mark 40. 40. Again, after second, after last two units, that is third and fourth one, second assignment, which is of marks 40. So 40 plus 40, 80, that will be reduced to 20. This is C. In same exam and same exam, both of 30 marks each at the end of semester on the same day, it will be conducted and it will be online. In same exam, first two units, and same exam, last two units. Okay, what's about during practical, you have 6 experiments. So after 3 experiment, after 3 experiment, we'll conduct first one quiz, which is of 30 marks based on first 3 experiment. Okay, after last 3 experiment, again, another quiz of 30 marks, 30 plus 30, 60, that will be reduced to 25. Okay, this is TW. Now which one left? SCE. Once we finish six experiments, its performance in first 6 week, whatever the rest weeks is related to SCE. Means in first week, once 6 weeks over, in seventh week, we'll ask you to select one topic. Suppose what we can say in agricultural, that is 2 cents moisture content. And if moisture content in the soil are less, then automatically that motor should get on, and like this. So sensors, including sensor, means like this topic you can select. Okay. Or smart dustbin, then rain sensor wipers, like this. Like this topics you can select, and on these topics are generator, how it works, motor, how it works, thermal power plant, its working, so on. So like this topics, which is a combination of electric and electronic circuit. So it is of 13, it is of 20 marks, SCE. So you have to give presentation on that. So based on that presentation topic, you will get SCE. That is 20 marks. Clear? Someone posted SCE. You got it? Clear, all of you? Can we start then?
Yes, first ma'am.
Unit? Okay. So we'll start with first unit. Can you see this? Another one, PDF, unit 1 DC circuit.
Yes, ma'am.
Observe the circuit here. Till that, I'll post attendance link. Observe circuit. So see, here link I posted for attendance. So all of you, please give your attendance for this lecture. No need not to post it on WhatsApp group. Yes. Are you listening? Yes. Hello. Yes, sir. Okay. Can you see in chat box attendance link?
Ma'am, please share in the WhatsApp group.
Okay, should I share it on WhatsApp also? Or no need? No need, because everyone can see the chat box.
No need.
No need, because... Okay, okay. So please enter everyone attendance for this lecture. Like this link I'll share. In division options are not there. You can type then. You can type in a D division. Right? Got it? Mohammed Uzair Sheikh, you asked this question. Got it? Okay.
There is no option to type.
Okay. Wait. I'll change that. Maybe some mistake. Wait a moment. GR number, complete roll number, full name, and division. Sorry, I'll write it short answer. Okay, now everyone, please check. Is it available now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. And give attendance. Everyone enter. So today we are going to start with unit 1. Okay. You take 2 minutes to enter attendance. We'll start with first unit and see this subject. If you concentrate in lecture, during lectures, it will be very easy for you, okay, to even score. But if you are not concentrating and you do login and not listening to me, then it will be very difficult subject for you to prepare on your own at home. Got it? Means what is the thing? What is the conclusion? Each and every point, whatever I explain in lecture, once you log in, you have to listen it carefully. Okay, you decide on your own whether you want to score in this subject or keep it as back, because this subject, it is not easy. Okay, it is difficult. Basic electrical engineering, difficult numericals you get asked in exam. No one will ask you easy numericals. Is this clear? But not that much difficult numericals that you can't solve. If you attend lecture, if you solve the numericals, whatever I give you, and if you do practice whatever the material I give numerical practice, then each and every numerical you can solve. Clear? So it's my advice to all of you, do not just log in during the lecture, listen each and every point carefully during this lecture. Okay, got it everyone? If you have any difficulty, so ask me. Okay. Okay, so can we start now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So see, that is the first unit. First unit, title is DC circuits. Okay, so what exactly we are going to do in this unit? You are going to simplify. You are going to solve DC circuits. You are going to analyze DC circuit. Simplification of DC circuits. Analysis of DC circuits. Okay, means what? To find out unknown parameters. Okay, suppose in this circuit, simple example I'm going to take. No one will ask you simple circuit. This is a simple circuit. If you see, DC voltage source is connected over here. This one is the DC voltage source, resistance. And value of both given to you, voltage source, its value is given, suppose 10 volt. Resistance, its value is given, suppose 1 ohm. Rishi, why you are writing something here? Blue mark, don't write. Here I can see names at my end. If anything you are going to do on screen, it will affect your marks. Don't behave so. Okay? I don't like such things. I can see names here. Who is going to write something on screen? Don't behave so. Okay, suppose voltage is 10 volt, resistance is 1 ohm, and you are going to find out the current. Once you find out the current, value of current means what? You have done simplification of a network, that is analysis of electric circuit, that is simplification of DC circuits. Okay, so analysis of DC circuit, that is simplification of DC circuit, means what? To find out unknown parameters. Current flowing through any resistance you find out, voltage drop across any resistance you find out, So that is called as simplification of electric circuit that you are going to do in this unit. Then for that purpose, what you are using, you are going to use Ohm's law, various laws and theorems you are going to use. You are going to use Ohm's law, then KVL, KCL, that is Kirchhoff's laws, Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law. Again, you are going to use superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem. Okay, so one by one we will see how you can apply Ohm's law, then Kirchhoff's current law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem. So you don't have any choice in exam. Circuit will be given to you and they will ask you simplified using, for example, superposition theorem, simplified using Thevenin's theorem, then that only you have to use. If you are using another one, you will not get marks for that, even if your answer is correct. What does it mean? You should be able to apply each and every law, each and every theorem. Okay, it's not so that out of four, I'll do only two. It's not so. Okay, you don't have choice there. Whatever given, that theorem, that law only compulsory you have to use. Okay, so what we are going to learn in this are our papers descriptive? See, it's an online exam and it will be descriptive. Means it will not only be objective type. Got it? Means theory questions also you will get asked there. You have to type there. Like this facility is done on that portal. Again, numericals also you have to solve and answer you have to write there. Okay, maybe they will ask you to solve numerical over there also. Means you can do the typing. So it is not objective type. It is descriptive type, subjective type it is, exam. It will be conducted online, but it is not only objective type. Clear? Maybe some weightage will be there, 5 marks for objective, but it is more weightage is there for subjective type of questions. Clear? Okay. So in this unit, what we are going to learn, clear? DC circuits, we are going to simplify using Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem. Okay. Now next. Now in this DC circuits. Now what do you mean by DC and what do you mean by AC? I think all of you know. Suppose we plot graph. This is x-axis, all of you know, of graph. This one is y-axis, all of you know, of graph. Suppose I want to plot this voltage behavior against time. So voltage you will take along x-axis or y-axis in this graph. Yes, I'll make this 100%. Okay. Now, is it clear? 100% I did. Tejas, is this clear now? I reduced that zoom option to 100%. Tejas, is it? Okay.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Y-axis.
Yes, voltage right. You will take along which axis?
Y.
Y, correct. And time you will take along?
X axis.
Why? Why voltage along Y axis and why time along X axis? Because when you plot graph, always dependent parameter you have to take along which axis? Here voltage depend on time or time depend on voltage?
Voltage depend on time.
Correct. Voltage depends on time. Means along y-axis which parameter you have to take? Dependent. Voltage. Dependent. Always. So in engineering or anywhere, medical field also, whenever you are going to plot a graph, So always dependent parameter you have to take along y-axis and independent parameter you have to take along x-axis. Clear? Now if you see on your left hand side, it's a voltage variation with respect to time and it's a DC voltage, right? DC means what? What is the meaning of DC? Magnitude and direction is constant. Okay, if you see along y-axis, it's a voltage, its magnitude is plotted. Consider it is 10 volt. So if you observe this 10 volt value is throughout constant, although the time is changing. And that is called as DC. Clear? DC means what? Its magnitude with respect to time always remains constant. It don't change. That is called as DC voltage or DC current. And if you observe its direction, that is also constant. Direction is constant means it is not minus 10. It is always plus 10 volt. Okay. So, here magnitude is always plus 10 volt, means direction is also constant. Direction is constant means what? Polarity is not changing. Take a DC battery. One terminal will always act as anode, another one always act as cathode. Got it? So, its polarity also remains constant. One terminal acts as anode, one terminal acts as cathode throughout. So, direction also remains constant and that is called as DC. DC means what? Clear? Okay. DC means what? Magnitude with respect to time remains constant and direction also remains constant. That is called as DC. What's about AC then? Yes. On your right hand side, you can see alternating waveform. Yes, you can tell D means DC means what? Direct current. Direct current. And AC means what? Alternating. So, what is the meaning of alternating? Which one? Alternating voltage, alternating current. So, which one we call alternating? Yes. Who can tell? Direction is not constant, correct? Again, means direction changes, means polarity continuously changes. Okay, again, what else? AC, observe the graph. Observe graph. Who can tell? You can unmute yourself. You can tell AC means what?
Its magnitude changes with time.
Correct. Its magnitude changes with time.
Direction changes over the time.
Correct. AC means what? Alternating voltage, alternating current means what? If you observe the graph which is there on your right hand side, its magnitude is continuously changing. Initially, it is here also. Along y-axis, voltage is there. Along x-axis, time is there. So, if you observe voltage is initially zero, then it is increasing. It reaches to maximum. From maximum value, again, it starts to decrease to zero. Then again, it is increasing, but its direction is now changes. Polarity changes. It is reaching to negative peak and again decreasing. Means with respect to time, its value changes, its direction changes. And that is called as alternating. Clear? Okay. Difference between DC and AC, clear? Direct current source, direct voltage source means what? Magnitude and direction continuously remains constant. And alternating voltage source, alternating current source means what? Magnitude and direction continuously changes with respect to time. Okay. That is the difference between AC and DC. Now, what we are going to do in first unit, you will be learning, you are going to simplify DC circuits. Means the source is DC voltage source or DC current source. In second unit, you are going to simplify AC circuit where the source is alternating voltage source. We are getting electricity at our home, right? If you observe at your home, electricity, whatever you are using, it's a single phase AC supply. Okay, single phase AC circuits we are going to simplify in second unit. Clear? Okay, is this clear to all of you? So in first unit we are going to simplify DC circuits where the source is DC voltage source or DC current source, and in second unit we are going to simplify AC circuits where the source is single phase AC, and in next to it, that is third unit, we are going to simplify three phase AC circuit where the source is three phase AC, and in the last unit, transformer. Clear? Okay, so first unit. So DC voltage source or DC current source. So you can see here the symbol. Out of these two, any one you can use for DC voltage source. It's a constant, constant DC voltage source, constant DC current source only included in your syllabus, not variable. Okay, so constant means independent sources, it is called, not dependent. Dependent sources not included in your syllabus, independent sources. What is the meaning of dependent, independent? Here means what? See here, suppose I am going to connect here 10 volt DC battery. And across this 10 volt DC battery, I am going to connect this resistance. This resistance value I am going to change continuously. Suppose initially 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm. So although you are changing value of resistance, this 10 volt will not change. This 10 volt, once you adjust in a battery 10 volt, it will remain constant. Whatever is the value of resistance, that is called as constant voltage source. Although you are changing load across it, value of voltage source will not change. This is called as independent voltage sources. Dependent voltage sources are also there, but that is not included in first. Okay. So for voltage source, any of the symbol you can use. Either the first one, you can see the longer one terminal is marked as positive, and shorter one terminal is marked as negative. DC, as it has constant direction, you can represent here polarity. One terminal as positive, one terminal as negative. Or you can use this another symbol also. Circle, any one of it positive, another one is negative. Okay, so this is a symbol for DC voltage source. Another one is DC current source. So if you are using first one, 1 ampere, arrow pointing upward means current of 1 ampere will flow like this in upward direction. If you are using this one symbol, what does it mean? If you observe here, arrow is downwards and magnitude is 2 ampere. This current of 2 ampere will start to flow in a downward direction. Okay, so this is the symbol for DC current source, and earlier one is the symbol for DC voltage source. Got it? Okay. So voltage, all of you know that is, it is denoted by V and unit is volt. Then current, it is denoted by I, unit is ampere. Now if you observe this circuit, what we have done, it's a DC voltage source is there. Across this DC voltage source, one resistance is connected. Control H. Okay, wait a moment. I do that. Someone posted, maximize the screen. Okay, sure. I do that. Control H I am doing. But it's not working. Now, quit to one full page. It's not wet. Now, check everyone. Is this clear? Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. ठीक है. सो दिस इज अबाउट द इन दिस सर्किट इफ यू ऑब्जर्व डीसी वोल्टेज सोर्स इज कनेक्टेड अक्रॉस रेजिस्टेंस. रेजिस्टेंस means all of you know how we define, this is the symbol for resistance. Symbol, I think everyone have studied symbol of resistance, and it is denoted by capital R. Unit is ohm. How we define resistance? It's opposition to the flow of current. Now across this voltage source, consider 10 volt DC voltage source battery is there. Across this, you are going to connect one resistance, so suppose of 2 ohm. Suppose of 2 ohm. Now, here, what will happen? The moment you switch on, what occurs in the circuit, whatever the electrons, this is called as complete one is the external circuit of a battery. Whatever is the inside circuit of battery, all of you know. One terminal acts as a one rod, and it acts as an anode. Another one, it acts as a cathode, and it is deep in some electrolytic material, right? Okay, so in whatever the construction inside a battery, that we are not going to consider over here. What we are considering circuit outside the battery. Take one battery, and whatever one positive terminal and one negative terminal, across it you connect one resistance of suppose 2 ohm. So now the moment you switch on battery 10 volt and connect one resistance across it, what happens? Electron starts to move in the circuit. So if you observe here, flow of electrons I have represented it, electron starts to move from negative terminal of battery to positive terminal of battery. See here, it is moving and electrons move toward positive terminal of battery. So flow of electrons. The moment electron starts to flow in the circuit means what? Current is flowing in the circuit. So flow of electrons is called as flow of current, and it is denoted by capital I, unit is ampere. Clear? Okay. So here electrons are moving in which direction? Clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Anti-clockwise.
Correct. Okay. Electrons are moving in anti-clockwise direction. So again in the same, see this one diagram, flow of electrons is the same circuit is there. Electrons are moving in anti-clockwise direction. But whenever we are going to simplify electric circuit, we are going to find out unknown parameters. You have to represent in the circuit current direction. So current direction, how it is used, which one current direction is used? Conventional. Conventional direction of flow of current. And what is it? Conventional direction of flow of current? It is opposite to the flow of electrons. How electrons flow? This one I explained to you. That is from negative terminal of battery to the positive terminal of battery through this external resistance, right? Opposite to that. That is in the anti-clock, in the clockwise direction. See, current is, it starts from positive terminal of battery and it moved toward negative terminal of battery. And this one direction, which is opposite to flow of electrons, is called as conventional direction of flow of current. Whenever we are going to simplify electric circuit, any book you refer, you find they use which one current direction? Conventional. Clear? And what is conventional current direction? Current always starts from positive terminal of battery and it moves over negative terminal of battery. Okay? Which is a reverse to flow of electrons. And even if you use reverse direction, that is same as that of electrons, same answer you will get. Suppose voltage drop you get asked to find out across some resistance, you will get same answer only with conventional, if you are getting answer plus 5 volt, with the direction of flow of electrons, you will get it minus 5 volt. That is only the difference. Clear? Any current direction you can use, either as same as that of flow of electrons or reverse, that is conventional. Answer, same answer you will get, only the difference is in the sign. With conventional, if you are getting plus 5 volt, with another one, reverse one, you will get minus 5 volt. Any book you refer, which one they use? Conventional. So, in this unit also, to simplify circuits, whenever there is a need to mark branch current direction, we'll show how current always starts from positive terminal of battery and it moves toward negative terminal. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Means which one direction you have to use?
Yes, ma'am.
Conventional. From where you will show start of current? So here same circuit, electrons is called as, when the electron starts to move, it is called as current is flowing in the circuit. Whenever there is a potential difference, then only electrons flow. If no potential difference is there, then electrons will not flow. This point is at negative potential, another point is at positive potential, that's why electrons are moving. If two equipotential points are there, no flow of electrons, no flow of current will be there. Okay. Next point, Ohm's law. Ohm's law, all of you know, V is equals to IR. This is the Ohm's law equation. Whenever you are going to apply Ohm's law, what we assume? Temperature remains constant. Okay. What we assume? Temperature remains constant. See, in 12th you may have studied effect of temperature on metal. Have you studied effect of temperature on metal, its resistance? What is it? Who can tell? Who can tell effect of
resistance increases versus time?
Resistance increases with
temperature.
Temperature, correct. Then resistance you would take along which axis? Resistance depends
y-axis.
On temperature, or temperature depends on y-axis. Resistance?
Correct.
Resistance depends on temperature. So suppose for copper, if you take copper, aluminium, silver, gold, all of you know, these are the good conductors of current. For the flow of current, for the flow of electricity, copper or aluminium is used. Silver and gold not used. Okay, silver and gold also good electricity conductors. But which one is used? Copper and aluminium. And among copper and aluminium, conductivity of copper is more than aluminum. Okay. But if you are using copper, what happens? Cost increases. Got it? So, aluminum, if you use, its conductivity compared to copper is less. Aluminum is cheap compared to copper. Copper is costly compared to aluminum. Okay. But what happens with both? If you are using, going to design, one conductor, or going to take one conductor for the flow of 1 ampere of current. One is made up of copper, another one is of aluminium. So, for copper, if you observe, its size is less of that conductor compared to aluminium. Means if you are using copper, size of that conductor will be less. Suppose one machine you are going to design, motor or generator. There you will find windings are there. That windings are made up of copper only. Why? Because if you are using copper, size of that conductor, its diameter, its length, less. Okay. So, but costing will be more. Reverse is the case for aluminium. Aluminium, if you observe, for underground flow of electricity, if you know wherever there is not possible overhead transmission lines, what is used? Underground cables. Underground cables, they don't use copper. They use aluminium. Why? Because aluminium you are using, costing will be less, size will be more. okay, under the ground lots of space is there. So wherever there is space matters, go for copper. Space doesn't matter, space criteria doesn't matter, go for aluminum. Okay, but if you are using copper, like in motor, generator, transformer, size matters. Okay, that these devices, these instruments, machines should be small in size. So you will find in motor, generator, transformer, its windings are made up of copper because their size matters. Costing increases and conductivity is also more there of copper. That's why losses will be less. Okay, I square R loss. When you pass a current through some copper resistance with resistance R, copper losses takes place. That is I square R. Heat is produced, right? So if you are using copper, as its conductivity is more, means resistance is less, I square R losses will be less. But if you are using aluminium compared to copper, in aluminium losses will be more. But if you are using aluminium, size will be more, but cost will be less. So where is the cost criteria? Go for aluminium. Okay, size will increase, losses will be more. Wherever size matters, go for copper. Copper you are using, costing increases, losses will be less, efficiency will be more. You know, all of you know, in every system, losses are more, lesser the efficiency. Losses are less, more the efficiency. And we want more efficient devices. Got it? Someone posted, isn't there is an increase in temperature with increased resistance? Heat will be more, that is true. But see what happens here. When we pass current through some conductor, in that case, current you are passing means what? Electrons are moving. So electrons are moving, heat is produced during this process because opposition get offered to the flow of current. Okay, and resistance increases. So here temperature is increasing, resistance is increasing. Resistance depends on temperature. Like this we can see. Okay. So as temperature increases, resistance increases. Like this is the case. So resistance is increasing. This all of you know for metals. Now what Ohm's law says? Ohm's law, what it says, V by I is constant, or V is directly proportional to I. What does it mean? Resistance we are going to assume constant, means we are going to neglect the effect of temperature. But practically what happens for metals, as you go on increasing temperature or as their temperature increases, resistance is not constant, it changes. But according to Ohm's law, we are going to assume it as constant. So this is called as, like this, Ohm's law you are applying means what? Effect of temperature you are going to neglect. So whatever the results you are getting, whatever the analysis you are doing, that is called as linear analysis. Okay, but in the system, if you are going to consider the effect of temperature also, that with the change in temperature, resistance is changing. Considering this, if I am analyzing the system, I am solving the system and I am finding the unknown parameters, means you are considering non-linearity, and such analysis is called as non-linear analysis. Okay, you will get more accurate results if you are considering non-linearities. Temperature is one of the non-linearity, friction is one of the non-linearity. You consider the effect of friction, you consider the effect of temperature while analyzing the system, more accurate results you will get. And that is called as non-linear analysis, which is difficult. Okay. But what is done in some systems? They use linear methods. Means what? Neglect the effect of friction, neglect the effect whenever there is a motion. Okay. Neglect the effect of friction, neglect the effect of temperature. means you are not considering the effect of non-linearities, and that is called as linear system analysis. In first year, only linear system analysis is included in your syllabus. Okay, so Ohm's law means what? We are going to assume temperature is constant, means resistance remains constant. Resistance is not changing with the change in temperature, but this is not actually the practical case. Clear? Okay, so consider linear system analysis we are doing. V is equals to IR, resistance remains constant, means effect of temperature we are going to neglect. We will stop here. Okay, attendance, hope everyone have given. Okay, I'll stop. Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Stopping in next lecture.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.